beginning, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Welcome to Chikuni Parish. I bless the body of Alice Maguire with the holy water that recalls her baptism, of which St. Paul writes, "All of us who were baptized into Christ Jesus were baptized into his death. By baptism into his death, we are buried together with him, so that just as Christ was raised from the dead by the glory of the Father, we too might live a new life. For if we have been united with him by the likeness to his death, so shall we be united with him by the likeness to his resurrection." On the day of her baptism, on her day of her baptism, she put on Christ. In the day of Christ's coming, may she be clothed with glory. When she was still alive, she would bring herself to the church. Now that she is dead, as Christians, we go with her in the church.
Extend the welcome to Father Samuel Mwati and This is a celebration, this is a thanksgiving. When I heard how long Sister Alice has been, I say we are not celebrating a funeral, but we are celebrating a life well lived. But as human beings, before short of God's glory, for those moments, let us acknowledge our sins and ask God for his forgiveness. I confess
to all mighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in all that I have done and in all that I have perished in. Through my fault, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask your sin.
Alice Maguire, who was fallen asleep in Christ, may be joined to rise again and show him. With his command, he will be in the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
spirit of faith, we also speak because we believe. We know that God, who raised the Lord Jesus to life, will also raise us up with Jesus and take us together with you into his presence. All this is for your sake, and as God's grace reaches more and more people, they will offer to the glory of God more prayers of thanksgiving. For this reason, we never become discouraged, even though our physical being is gradually decaying. Yet our spiritual being is renewed day after day. And this small and temporary trouble will suffer to bring us a tremendous and eternal glory, much greater than the trouble. For we fix our attention not on things that are seen, but on things that are unseen. And what can be seen lasts only for a moment, but what cannot be seen lasts forever. For we know that when this tent we live in, our body here on earth, is torn down, God will have a house in heaven for us to live in, a home he himself has made, which will last forever. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Gospel of the Lord.
Thank you.
Good morning once more.
Good morning.
When I look at the years that Sister Alice did, her whole life, also the years that she lived in Zambia. In Zambia, is it 1957 when she arrived? Yeah, she's older than Zambia itself. She's older than my classes. I was not yet born when she arrived. They received her, and there was continuation of Catholicism by us, who were not born by them, to send her off. I think this is self-emptying. This is love, to be able to come all the way since 1957 to lead your life, one's life here in Zambia. Myself, I just flew out of the country for just 24 hours. I was already missing Chima. And immediately I came back, I said I missed Chima. But I'm looking at her, who left her country before independence. She stayed and died here. This is a big lesson to me and to each one of us to have a heart of self-emptying, to give yourself to Christ. And you don't just say it, but even in your deeds, it should show. Today in the gospel we hear about poverty. You know, practically speaking, poverty in itself is not a blessing, but it's a misfortune. You know, all the qualifying things that we have heard about Matthew's Beatitudes, poverty, hunger, weeping, hatred, exclusion, all these are misfortunes. And I think no parent, not anyone of us, even God, would want us to experience this. Yet, it has been mentioned. But we can understand what it means when we go beyond towards the end of Matthew's gospel. There's a quote that says, you know, if you're persecuted, if you're hungry, if you're poor, on account of the Son of Man, then you qualify to be blessed. So you don't just suffer for the sake of suffering. The context this gospel was written, I would say, it was just at the beginning of Christianity. For us to understand what this gospel means, we have to understand where it was started. Who was Jesus preaching to? You know, people were just converting to Christianity. Maybe Christianity was not there before, but they were accepting the new message, the gospel, at that time. So let's use converting. They were coming to Jesus from their families. And the families, we can call them, they were not Christians. So it meant that when you convert to the new religion or to the new following Christ, then it means your family abandons you. If you are qualified for a certain amount of money, you lose it. For a land, you lose it. So you become persecuted. So those are the people Christ was preaching to. Are those people, when they accepted his message, they were forsaken by their family. They had nowhere to go but in life. Because if you don't have land, you don't have property, you don't have anything, you are nothing. And they hold on to Christ and they say, this is the only thing that I'll hold on to. And those are the people that Jesus was preaching to during this gospel. But how does this apply to our gathering today? I think I don't need to stress too much. She left everything to come here and to hold on to where? Christ. only Christ. You hold on to Christ. Therefore, you are blessed. So it's a blessing to have her. It's a blessing to be here. We share the blessing because of her great grace that she was doing. We hear of the sea, and we hear during her last life that she was working in Dora at the hospice. Yes, go and visit the sick, and that's what she was doing. So she left everything and to hold on to Christ. Maybe also we have our own securities, whether in religious life, whether in the families, wherever you are, you have your own security that is not Christ. Maybe it's a moment to be poor so that you are blessed. To go beyond what you think is the security and hold on to Christ, because you'll be blessed. And therefore, you are going to be saved, as we hear in wisdom to say, the souls of the righteousness are in the hands of God, and there shall be no torment which is going to touch them. Maybe let us transcend our securities as she did. She transcended her security and believed that Christ is where I'm going to hold on to. Christ is going to be everything in my life. There is a thinker called Socrates. He says, the first stage in search for knowledge is to realize that we are all ignorant. So if you need knowledge, bring yourself down and say, I'm very ignorant. In the same way, if you want to be blessed and holy, we should realize that we are all sinners and poor. We are always in hunger for God's mercy and forgiveness. I'm very sure that Sister Alice, she was always hungry. She always had hunger for God's mercy and for God's love. I think as we put her to rest, maybe we can get one bit of how she did. Self-emptying, just as Christ did. Self-emptied himself when he was comfortably staying with the Father and came down to die for us on the cross. Maybe each and every one of us, we can look into our lives and say, what am I doing? Am I already self-emptying? If we are not, maybe it's time to kneel and pray so that God may help us, that the Holy Spirit may help us to be able to experience on what it means to empty ourselves and be able to do good in the name of the Lord. May God bless you, in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.
I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the Keeper of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Amen.
Let us now bring our prayers to the table of the Lord. God Almighty, we thank you for the life of Sister Alice, for the things that she did to show that she was baptized and to show that she was a true Christian. Help us to learn so that God, as we are still living, we may be able to follow you and to do the things that your Holy Spirit empowers us to do. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
Pray us, Lord.
Gracious and loving God, we ask that our sister Alice, who once received the white garment of baptism, be admitted now forever to the company of the saints. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, graciously hear us.
We pray for all those who mourn the loss of Sister Alice, her family members and relatives, her religious sisters, the religious sister of charity, and all those whose lives she touched. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
We pray that the congregation of the religious sisters of charity who received Sister Alice into their membership be blessed with others who, like Sister Alice, hear the call to the love of God and serve the poor. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
We pray for all those who at any time supported Alice in her ministry, and especially those who took care of her with such loving dedication in her final years of illness. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
We commend into your loving arms all those who have gone before us, family, friends, benefactors, and now our dear Alice. May they and all those who have rest in peace. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
These prayers we have uttered are those in our hearts we entrust them to God through Christ our Lord, as we say, Hail Mary.
Full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death.
Thank you. sisters, that my sacrifice and the Lord's may be accepted to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifices of your hands for the praise and the glory of God's name, for our good and the good of His holy Church.
We humbly present to you these sacrificial offerings, O Lord, for the salvation of your servant, Alice Maguire. We beseech your mercy, that she who did not doubt your son to be a loving Savior may find in him a merciful judge, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We raise them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. In him the hope of blessed resurrection has dawned, that those who sudden by the certainty of time might be consoled by the promise of immortality to come. Indeed, for your faithful Lord, life is changed, not ended. And when this earthly dwelling turns to dust, an eternal dwelling is made ready for them in heaven. And so with the angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory as without end. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
Gloria, oh, my.
you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit.
Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Bishop-elect Rafa, and all the clergy.
Remember your servant, Alice Maguire, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that she was united with your Son in a death like his, may also be one with him in his resurrection.
Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with the blessed apostles, with Saint Joseph, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages. We may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Amen.
And the Saviour's command and come by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be your name, your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil, gracious in God, peace in our days, and by the help of your mercy, may you always free from sin and save from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit. You take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord God, whose Son left us in the sacrament of his body, food for the journey, mercifully grant that, strengthened by it, our sister Alice Maguire may come to the eternal table of Christ, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
May I now invite my brother priest closer to the casket for the final communion. Faith in Jesus Christ, we reverently bring the body of our sister to be buried in its human imperfection. Let us pray with confidence to God, who gives life to all things, that you will raise up this mortal body to the perfection and the company of the saints. May God give her a merciful judgment and forgive all her sins. May Christ, the Good Shepherd, lead her safely home to be at peace with God, our Father. And may she be happy forever with all the saints in the presence of the eternal King.
Thank you.
charity on the passing of our dear aunt, Sister Alice Maguire. We are especially thinking of Sister Alice's close friends and community in her home, Zambia. At this time, and we are so grateful for the wonderful care you gave to Alice in the recent months. For us, Sister Alice's 3 yearly Irish sabbaticals during the later 1960s and 70s normally started with a trip to the airport, sometimes extremely late or early hours, to pick her up after a long journey from Zambia. Alice's first port of call was sometimes the convent in Stamford Street, after which she made the short journey to her sister, our beloved mother Mary, and the Heine family in Park Road. The front bedroom became Alice's base for the next 3 months, and she enjoyed a highly active life here, visiting colleagues and friends around Dublin and being part of our family's trips and activities during this time. In those days, all holidays were local, so Alice saw much of the south and west of the country when she was here. Regular visits here were also made to her brother Owen and Olive, the Maguire side of the family in Galway, where Alice always enjoyed the wonders of the west of Ireland in great company. Alice also spent much of time with her dearly departed sister Eileen's family in Bray, County Wicklow, and her brother Noel and Dimplia in Rathdowney, County Leash. During this time, Alice regaled us with the amazing stories of her life and friends in Zambia, and we hung on every word. Indeed, it is fair to say that our family knew all about Zambia before we ever knew anything about Africa. Alice always brought souvenirs of local handcraft home with decorative spear and arrow, having pride of place in our sitting room hall. Every time she was here, Alice always took the opportunity to promote your order's activities in Zambia. She would visit our primary school and show combined groups of classes, slides and artifacts depicting everyday life in townships that were so far away. We were always amazed. Alice also shared her experiences with Parish and other groups such as the ladies' clubs, which were extremely popular at this time. So when Alice departed for Zambia after her 3 months sojourn, she always traveled a little but heavier with funds, clothes, and other items she shared so generously with her township on her return. The regular airmail letters we received from Alice after such a visit would sometimes include pictures of the local townsfolk wearing a Dublin football jersey or carrying a Don's store bag. This was wonderful to see. These names might not mean much to everybody here, but to an Irish person they would. Auntie Alice and our families kept in regular touch between her visits through those small airmail letters, and sometimes during subsequent years, a phone call could be arranged, which was wonderful. During one visit home in the late 1990s, we were able to show Alice the day the Zambian news on our own computer, which was amazing. Alice shared in many happy family occasions during these years, and she was a wonderful support from afar during sadder times. We were also privileged to share some very happy days with Alice during her last visit home in 2012. About 12 months ago, our families got word that Sister Alice was poorly. We are most grateful for your community's warm and loving embrace of Auntie Alice during this time. This is truly clear from the pictures and videos we have seen in recent days. We are sure that this was a great team effort, and therefore hope you will all not mind if we mention Sister Claire especially. Thank you so much, Sister Claire, for the love and care that you and your colleagues provided.
lovely town in the Midlands called Portalington. Count Leos in the year 1925 on the 7th of November. Her parents were Thomas and Catherine Maguire, and she was christened in the local parish church. She had one brother and two sisters who have since gone to the Lord. May their souls rest in peace. Sister Alice entered the Sisters of Charity in Newtown, Dublin, in July 1951. And after the initial period of postulancy, was received into the congregation and given the name Sister Mary Coleman. Later, she reverted to her baptismal name, Alice, which she retained for the rest of her life. She was professed in 1954 and made her final commitment to God in 1957. She spent her entire life, with the exception of 2 years, in Bristol University, in pastoral ministry and social work. Her devotion to duty was unique and unparalleled in history. Her energy was limitless. She never used a watch. She preferred to live by the sun and was always on time. She made the rest of us ashamed who were consulting our watches and yet failed to be on time. Her ministry to the poor and vulnerable in our society was spread over a wide area from Bath in England in 1954 to the end of her active years in Dola, Zambia in 2018. During that long period, she served in Chikuni, was her first mission, where she arrived in 1957. Then Namara, where she was found a member in 1963. Later she went to Mamba, and then Maiva in Solwezi, and finally in Dola. In 2018, she fell and broke her hip and was rushed to the Italian hospital in Lusaka. She survived the surgery and received a new hip. But her upward activities in visiting the poor and vulnerable came to an abrupt end. Sister Alice touched many lives during her long life. Her name is a password in the Monse Diocese. She visited many villages in remote areas, conducted prayer services to the poor who had never heard of God, ending the services with a generous sprinkling of holy water. She organized liturgical services in villages where priests only visited once a month. This service was greatly appreciated by the local people, who as time went on, were able to organize their own liturgical services. Sister Alice was a very good listener, and the problems of the poor, though overwhelming, always sent her people away with a fresh hope and courage to face reality. In Mamba, she had a special day, which she called Sister Alice's Outpatient Department. That meeting was always well attended, and people went away tired but happy. Sister Alice had great understanding of the plight of refugees and worked hard in Neva refugee camp to try and bring back some semblance of humanity to the many refugees there. Here she worked with Catholic Relief Services, which was involved in similar work of relief for refugees. She also spent time making some ways, doing pastoral work in parishes and villages. In 1998, she was She spent many hours at different places, praying and preparing the dying to meet their Creator. Her supply of cold water was always in demand. She also visited Dollar Central Hospital on a regular basis, and the patients loved her sprinkling them with the holy water. She also visited a home for the elderly people in Dola. Her ministry took her wherever she saw a need. Her devotion to the poor and vulnerable was wonderful and inspirational. Finally, in April 2018, her active apostolate came to an abrupt end. She was changed to the regional house of the Sisters of Charity in Lusaka. In recent years, she has suffered many illnesses and had had to be hospitalized a few times. But the end came peacefully and quietly on March 6th at 08 hours. Her long life of 97 years had lived up to the motto of the congregation, "The Charity of Christ Ages Us On." In her effort to help the poor and vulnerable in our society, as Venerable Mother Mary Elizabeth gave such an example. May her soul rest in peace.
Amen.
Parish priest, Father Vincent Chikuni, Father Michael Walsh, and then Father Sam and Father John. Also Sister Mary Zimba, who is representing our leadership team here. The representatives of the three nursing homes, self-care nursing so many ways during Sister Alice's life here in Zambia. And over the past days since Sister Alice's demise, you have been communicating with us, with all of us, praying with us, and offering us condolences. Thank you very much. The arms, that's Mary Religious and Isaac Association of Zambian Clergy, also for your support and celebrating the Eucharist with us, both in Lusaka here, supporting us all the time. Thank you very much. The three groups who lovingly provided health care services for Sister Alice in her last years. First, the self-care nursing services, particularly Ronald and Dr. Hamza, and your carers. We thank you very, very much. Nkululeko Nursing Agency and your carers. The Loving Touch Home Health Care, in particular, Mary Fenta and Charity Katongo. Our novices who visited Sister Alice daily prayed the rosary with her and had lovely chats with her, which inspired them on their journey of religious life. Thank you, Sister Alice. Sister Alice Maguire is a heroine. She was a gentle soul with everyone, but worked really hard, lovingly, and with passion for the people of God. She lived as she offered herself completely to God and the service of God's people, the vulnerable. She served in the three dioceses in Ghana, starting from Mwanza Diocese, here in Chikuni as we meet, where she lived with Sister Mary Charles Walker, Namwana, Mamba, where she made a great impact in Mamba in Chimonsero village, with her friend Basilica, who even named her firstborn daughter Sister Alice. Siameja, Kafamila, as we heard, she had great stories going on the border, you know, when the cars couldn't pass there, flying over bridges, but being protected by God. Amen. The list goes on. Amen. Then she went to Ndola Diocese, where she passionately and lovingly served the people of Chichetekelo Hospice. As we already heard, she worked with Ms. Liz Sean and Wasofi. Every day we would hear of these names, Wasofi, Liz, what they would do with her, this one we would have. Then at St. Teresa's Home for the Elderly and St. Anthony Orphanage, where she worked with the Dominicans, particularly with Sister Philomena. German Dominican. Sister Alice has fought the good fight. She has run the race and reached the finish honorably. May she joyfully receive her crown of glory from the Lord she loved so much. May God bless you and protect you all as you travel back. And for Sister Alice, I think, to rest in peace.
instructions and say, I'll meet you in Galilee. Why in Galilee? Because that's where our whole thing started. We are humbled to have Sister Alice. Where all things started in Zambia.